Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. My name is Emily and I make a bunch of videos about Salesforce. Today we're going to be going over org-wide defaults. This is probably the number one thing that bothers me about Salesforce is org-wide defaults, just because the naming conventions and how to access them, and it is a little bit tricky to access them. Org-wide defaults kind of set the basis of security, and of course you can amend security depending on your org-wide settings. Most settings, because Salesforce has added more security options, your org-wide default, of course, is going to be your baseline. You can restrict access from your, excuse me, you can open up access from your org-wide defaults. You cannot usually restrict access from your org-wide defaults, and your org-wide defaults, again, is your baseline. So let's go ahead and hop into the setup, and I'll show you how to get there. So let's go ahead. From the quick find, we're going to go to sharing settings. I don't know why it's not called org-wide defaults. It is really annoying to me, but that's a story for another day. And here we can see our org-wide defaults at the very top. So, as you can see, a lot of these are private. You can open up access from private objects. You cannot usually restrict access from public objects. So, things like profiles, permission sets, those things are going to open up access from your org-wide defaults. From here, we are able to edit our org-wide defaults. So let's say we wanted our leads to be public, and we can choose public read-only for external access and public read-only for internal access. Why this could be important, if you might want to see all leads and have everyone see all leads in case they come into contact with them, and that way we can better use duplicate tools or deduplicate tools. Let's see other things that we might be able to see. Change request. This will probably want to be private if you're submitting a change request. Let's see. Opportunities. Let's go ahead and search for opportunities up here at the top. Probably. That's a little funky. Okay, it is public read write for internal access. However, I kind of want to restrict that to private because opportunities can include sensitive information. External access is also private. One thing before we go is I want to talk about the grant access using hierarchies. So, hierarchy Salesforce. Or Salesforce's hierarchy is used also for individual record sharing between your boss and subordinates. So it is on default and it will be checked for standard objects. If you had a custom object, you could choose to not have this. If you're taking the admin exam soon, that is going to be a really key thing to hit home on is standard objects. It is by default checked on, but custom objects, you can toggle that off. So what this will enable it to do, let's say you had a sales team and sales managers. So let's say you had a sales manager A, he led team A. And then you had a sales manager B, he led team B. Team members that are under team A, all of their records with the hierarchy would be viewable, accessible by manager A. Same with team B. Any of their records, the team members, would be viewable by manager B. However, it does not work laterally. What that means is team A would not be viewable by team manager B. The same with team B would not be manageable by team A. Hopefully that made sense. So accessing hierarchies only goes up. Sometimes it can go down, but usually not. So those are org-wide defaults. Again, these set a baseline of privacy in your org. So If it is private, you can use tools such as profiles and permission sets to open up access to different objects. And this is also going to be an object level security thing. You can grant access using hierarchies. Hierarchies are for specific records and record level security. So I hope that you found this helpful, and hopefully you were able to change the org-wide default if you're looking for that specific purpose at this video. If you found it helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe. And if you have any questions, be sure to leave them down below in the comments, and I'll try and get back to you as fast as possible. Thank you so much for watching. Check out my courses down below. Catch you in the next one.